canals, railways, and now roads again. Turn off the Bath Road near Hungerford. You'll cross the railway and come to Crofton, the engine house at the summit of the Kennet and Avon Canal, the only inland water link between Bristol and London. That tall chimney and engine house have been there for 150 years, pumping water into the canal all that time. It's done by one of the oldest steam engines still working in the world, a Cornish beam engine. Know what a beam engine is? While you're looking at its beautiful rhythmic motion, I'll try to tell you. The beam is like the top of a pair of scales. That's the pivot in its center. And the beam's worked up and down by a steam piston on one side, which operates a suction pump on the other. Down goes the rod on the pump side, carried down by its own weight. The steam piston draws it up again, and the pump sucks up water, which is eventually spurted out into the canal. The manager of the local electricity board told me that a few years ago he was asked to estimate for electrical machinery to take its place, but he found that electricity couldn't do the pumping as cheaply as this old beam engine, which is looked after by one man whom you've seen greasing the piston. James Watt built engines like this, and his firm supplied this one to the canal in 1808. I don't see how anyone can look at it, whether he knows how it works or not, without being moved by its precision and beauty. Listen to the strong, satisfied noises it makes. This engine had to be built to lift the water up to the top of the canal to make up for wastage. There's the sound of the water as it surges up and ripples away down to the canal and out into the Wiltshire silence. The Kennet and Avon was constructed by John Rennie, the great bridge engineer, more than a century and a half ago. You can see it alongside the Bath Road from Reading to Hungerford, and Crofton, I suppose, is about 4 miles west of Hungerford.